issue of immediate concern that happened after a particular point in time. And that's my contention. Again, I have information to demonstrate that with all of the backup documentation, but without having the opportunity to question those people that supposedly made comments. And I can tell you right now, there is tremendous amount of pressure as on those employees, as they are y'all, I know, in this situation, being county employees, because of the level of this situation. And there is concern there, and I recognize that, but I think I at least have the opportunity, should have the opportunity, to ask those questions and present those opinions to you. And I will leave it with that, Mr. Chairman, and hopefully that y'all will see fit to provide me with a hearing where I can actually question those employees and staff and provide you with the information that you need. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Any questions?
I have documentation to council members where I sent letters to them trying to clarify some of the misinformation to give them the benefit of the doubt that, you know, the things that they were saying maybe they had forgotten or weren't aware of, and that I left them with a very positive message and one that explained that I wanted all of us to be proud of what we're doing and that I appreciate their support and, you know, really tried to make a positive image. As a matter of fact, even in so much as a news article that's documented here, that there were comments made by Mr. Britt and I think Mr. Nutt as well, that we had a failure to communicate. And at that point, the reporter asked me, do you agree with that statement? And I said, yeah, I believe we do. You know, that there were times that I was given that opportunity, and I did share that, both with council members and with Mr. Breed. I have emails with Mr. Breed where I communicate with him that I'm trying my best to make this thing work. And I know that there are forces bigger than us behind this, but I'm trying my best to get this thing right. Mm-hmm. And I've got documentation of that.
Mr.
Caden,
prior to I'd like to stipulate something because we're going over a lot of time here. When did you realize that there were issues with your performance? What was the earliest time that you realized there may have been issues with your performance in parks?
I believe the first conversation that Glenn Breed and I had was May the 5th.
Of this year.
As I stated, I've been employed with Spartanburg County 15 years, never had a bad evaluation, never been written up, even counseled. And May 5th was the first time that Glenn Breed expressed to me those very things that I've shared with you, that we need to do something to improve the image of the commission, and made similar statements to what Mr. Hiff had stated. But it was at that point when that concern was expressed.
To your knowledge and looking at your evaluations, you are correct. They were all very good evaluations. The last one that I saw was June of 2004. To your knowledge, were there some just missing from your folder, or was that indeed the last time?
The county failed to conduct an evaluation in 2005, to my knowledge. 2006 is when the commission was created, and at that point, the commission did not provide me with written evaluations.
If I understood you correctly, was there ever a plan of improvement?
No, ma'am.
Anything to follow?
No, ma'am.
Any written instructions?
No, ma'am.
That brought up another question, Chairman. So once the parks came under the commission, it would have been their responsibility to assess you and not the county administrator?
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. And I would share just quickly, that the final decision to abolish the commission was made in the May council meeting, and that was exactly the time that these interviews were conducted. So there was about a two-week window there between when the commission was abolished and I was terminated.
There was something that it seemed like was pretty frequent in your previous performance reviews. I mean, I've got here in 2001, 2003, and 2004, public relations was mentioned as some an area for you to have improvement on. Do you think you were working on that? Was it something that you were working on to improve?
That is reference to specifically the council's effort to get the parks department at the time out in the public eye more to demonstrate what we were doing. And honestly, I was feeling my way through that process to know how out front I needed to be in trying to address how we deal with public issues. Also, I will say that's also a period of time when we were dealing with youth athletic issues and other things where those can be very contentious, and a lot of reasons for that. That was a period of time that I think those issues were addressed, and I think we dealt with pretty well. As a matter of fact, as I mentioned, those recognitions and awards, we were recognized as the state's outstanding agency, I believe, three times while I was director of Parks and Recreation, and I was actually the professional of the year for the state of South Carolina in 2003.
I could have found this out with personnel, but how many supervisors did you have under you, and how many employees overall to manage?
Specifics.
I don't have to be too specific. I just need a general idea.
About seven supervisors.
And did any of your employees come to you at any time and voice any of the concerns that seemed to be mentioned in these interviews?
No, ma'am, they did not. And, again, if I had the opportunity for witnesses, I would be able to share that neither did they approach any of our commissioners over that five-year duration, which they had more than ample opportunity at employee gatherings, Christmas time, spring time. We did a picnic with staff. They also interacted with staff during commission meetings where each one of the division heads and a few other support staffs provided updates each month to the commissioners that I provided them full exposure to our commission members and for our commission members to get to know them. And to my knowledge, and I think they would support this, never were they approached by any of the staff members that had concern with my leadership or any other issues.
Think you gave them not the location or the setting or the time, but your personal character, that opportunity that they can speak openly about?
Absolutely. There's always a perceived distance with department heads by staff that they're concerned about. I never could figure that out, but that they were not approachable sometimes, but I always communicated to staff my door was open, that they felt free in speaking with me. There were opportunities where we took staff to conferences with commissioners and, spent time together and never had any relationship issues. Certainly there are always gonna be times where you have to deal with performance-related issues, but none that dealt with my character, my leadership, and the things that I was accused of. And I think the pressure associated with, the train accident, which was very stressful as for everybody in the county, but especially so for the scrutiny that our staff went under, but also the commentary that was made about the commission for a couple of months by council members that put them under extreme stress, and they were all very concerned about employment, whether they were going to have employment. And that duress, I think, caused a lot of anxiety with people, which is understandable. But I do have, where I've issued letters to staff. We have meetings where I've been very positive and said, you know, guys, we're going to get through this, we're going to come out of it stronger, you know, and trying to keep them motivated and have a positive attitude in a very difficult time. So I'll just leave it there.
How did your staff feel about the commission being formed? How did they react? Was there any difference in attitude or performance for them with you? Did you perceive anything different?
The staff were very excited when the commission was formed. Now, I will tell you this, that over the course of that five-year period, we had a significant turnover in staff. A lot of our employees had retired, and we brought on an awful lot of young staff, I would say under 30 type staff, who had to be mentored and had to be helped in their positions. And a lot of the staff that are there now didn't know of how things functioned when we were a county department versus a commission. I can tell you that they were all very upset as the commission came under attack, because they knew of the successes that they had had. They knew of the efficiencies. They knew of all the positive things that were going on, and they were concerned that all of that would stop once the county, once the commission came under the county and they were no longer commission employees. So there were a lot of stresses and pressures that were placed on them in a very brief period of time.
You had a chance to read what your staff responded to in these interviews?
No, ma'am.
You have not.
As a matter of fact, my staff was told not to communicate with me as soon as I was terminated. So in my opinion, they were not given their rights to express themselves or to communicate. I don't know how you can stop people from communicating with other individuals, but they were all instructed not to communicate with me.
Thank you.
I have a question.
According to the ordinance that created the commission, and this was an issue of contention, that this was in some way, difficult document to read and hard to understand. I will provide you with a copy of it, and you can decide if you think it is very difficult to understand. It's 3 pages long. There were specific empowerments that were provided for in the ordinance. And I will read you the section specific to your question. And I believe I might have stated this in my statement. All persons employed by the district shall be employees of the district, described as an authority outside county government. So in essence, the commission was an entity created by the county to be a semi or quasi-independent organization that the county had oversight over, but maintained a separate fund and separate operating procedures and was supervised and managed by a group of 5 appointed volunteers, which were commissioners, to manage the parks and recreation effort. So by nature of the ordinance, it was designed to be an agency outside of county government, but appointed and created by the county.
Sick leave.